transitioning from human food to pet food has given me a lot of my creativity back, actually. I'm Bryan Angolia. I'm the senior food engineer here on the food team at Ollie, and I've been here for about just over 2 years. I started out actually going to school for culinary, and I was a chef at first. I moved into human food manufacturing and landed in a pet project several years ago, and it just kind of fit really well. Fell in love with kind of what I'm doing, who I'm feeding, and then it just kind of progressed from there. Dogs are a lot more appreciative of the end product that they receive. I've never seen a dog upset at the food that we put in front of them. I design the full nutrition recipes, make sure that each recipe is complete and balanced to the AAFCO standards, and any new recipes that we're coming up with for main meal consumption, I'll be working with those as well. So all of our recipes start benchtop in our kitchens at home. I do have a pantry of wholesome ingredients that I can pull in and test out in different recipes. All of our recipes start with meat from USDA certified facilities as kind of like the foundation and the first building block that designs our recipes. Then we layer in fruits, vegetables, grains, legumes as it's appropriate for the nutrition of the product. The kind of last step in the recipe development, we take a look at the 44 different nutrients that AAFCO requires us to put in the recipe. If we're short on any of those, we'll then top note it or supplement it with just a little bit of vitamins, minerals as needed. We'll also add in any additional benefit ingredients like salmon oil, which is adding omega-3 and 6 fatty acids to the product. One last check, we'll send it off for chemical analysis where we understand what exactly is in the food, making sure that we are checking all those 44 boxes to meet or exceed the profiles so that the dog has great nutrition.